Markle and Prince Harry really annoyed the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge with recent remarks about their plans for the future of their family, according to a royal expert, leaving commentators to question whether there was tension between the royal couples. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry really annoyed the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge with recent remarks about their plans for the future of their family, according to a royal expert, leaving commentators to question whether there was tension between the royal couples. Speaking on E! News, Ms. Bromley said, "Every year the Queen invites members of the royal family to stay at her Scottish estate, this year it's no different. But this year there is one expert claiming William and Kate may have delayed their Balmoral trip because they don't want to have a run-in with Harry and Meghan." According to royal reporter Robert Jobson, recent comments made by Harry and Meghan may have rubbed William and Kate the wrong way. Jobson says that when Harry recently declared in an interview that he and Meghan plan on only having two children, maximum, this is their bid to save the planet, it actually really annoyed the Cambridges who, of course, have three. The same commentator also notes that Meghan may have upset Kate by saying she didn't want to appear boastful by putting a picture of herself on the cover of British Vogue. If you recall, Kate Middleton did appear as a cover star for British Vogue in 2016, and by the way, she looked bloody amazing doing it. She added, "So is there really more tension between William and Kate and Harry and Meghan? Or is this the case of normal stress that comes from trying to schedule a family vacation? Honestly, when is planning a holiday not chaotic?" Despite the continued rift being cooked up by the trolls, Kate and Meghan appear to be putting on a united front. Almost all the evidence suggests the two women are getting along so well. They're often seen smiling in one another's company. This year, for the second time in a row, Kate and Meghan attended Wimbledon together. Writing in the Daily Mail last week, royal expert Robert Jobson claimed the Duke and Duchess could delay their trip to Balmoral to avoid seeing Harry and Meghan. He wrote, "As children, William and Harry relished their time together at Balmoral, spending entire summers there with their mother away from prying eyes. But today, it is understood William and his wife Kate may delay their trip until Harry and Meghan have returned to Windsor." He added, "The Duke of Sussex's latest woke outburst, in which he declared that he and Meghan plan to have only two children maximum in a bid to save the planet, may well have irked the Cambridges, who already have three. What will have fueled their disquiet, too, is Meghan's stint as guest editor on British Vogue's September issue. The Duchess insisted it would have been boastful to appear on the cover, but failed to mention that Kate became the Fashion Bible's cover star 2 years previously. The Duke of Sussex recently hinted in an interview that he and Meghan were only looking to have one more child for the benefit of the environment. He said, "I think, weirdly, because of the people that I've met and the places that I've been fortunate enough to go to, I've always had a connection and a love for nature. I view it differently now, without question. But I've always wanted to try and ensure that, even before having a child and hoping to have children." Dr. Goodall, worried about the worldwide population growth, warned Harry not to have too many babies. The Duke of Sussex, Prince Harry replied, "Two, maximum. But I've always thought, this place is borrowed. And, surely, being as intelligent as we all are, or as evolved as we all are supposed to be, we should be able to leave something better behind for the next generation." Meghan guest edited the September issue of British Vogue but did not place her the cover, thinking it was boastful to include herself in the edition. Speaking about the issue, Meghan said, "Guest editing the September issue of British Vogue has been rewarding, educational and inspiring. To deep dive into this process, working quietly behind the scenes for so many months, I am happy to now be able to share what we have created. A huge thanks to all of the friends who supported me in this endeavor, lending their time and energy to help within these pages and on the cover. Thank you for saying yes. And to Edward, thank you for this wonderful opportunity." British Vogue editor-in-chief Edward Enninful said, "To have the country's most influential beacon of change guest edit British Vogue at this time has been an honor, a pleasure, and a wonderful surprise. As you will see from her selections throughout this magazine, She is also willing to wade into more complex and nuanced areas, whether they concern female empowerment, mental health, race, or privilege. From the very beginning, we talked about the cover, whether she would be on it or not. In the end, she felt that it would be in some ways a boastful thing to do for this particular project. She wanted, instead, to focus on the women she admires. Kate, the Duchess of Cambridge, appeared on the cover of Vogue back in 2016, and Princess Diana was pictured on the front cover in 1981. Reports of a feud between both the Duke and Duchess of Sussex and William and Kate have circulated since Meghan joined the royal family.